is the season for jack-o'-lantern stuffed peppers. I'm gonna eat you. Get in my belly.
Oh, look. He has a friend.
I'm gonna eat you, too. Come out, come out, come out. Where? Oh. There you are. I've been looking around for you all day. Where have you been? I'm sorry. The silent treatment? You're giving me the silent treatment? Well, looks like I'll just have to show you what I do to those who give me the silent treatment. You know, the pumpkin wasn't the only gourd that was used for carving jack-o'-lanterns. It was actually a early 20th century concoction from Irish immigrants. You see, the story of the jack-o'-lantern starts with a guy named Stingy Jack. There's a few different versions of the folktale, but it said that Stingy Jack cheated death himself. Death wasn't too happy, so when he finally caught up with Stingy Jack, he didn't kill him. Didn't let him live either. He was kind of stuck in this between worlds type of scenario. And everything to Jack was very dark and very cold. The only thing that he had to light his way was a single ember that Death had given him. And Death, before he gave him this ember, hollowed out a turnip. The turnip is what housed the ember and what kind of lit Jack's path as he was walking. Well, the original jack-o'-lanterns were carved from turnips. The only problem is turnips don't keep very well. So around the turn of the century, when a lot of Irish immigrants were making their way to America, didn't have a lot of turnips to make jack-o'-lanterns with. So they picked the next best thing, a pumpkin. And since then, the pumpkin / jack-o'-lantern has been a Halloween staple.
An old deserted mansion on an old forgotten road, where the better ghosts and goblins always hang out. One night they threw a party in a manner a la mode, and they cordially invited all the gang out. At a dark, bewitching hour, when the fun was loud and hearty, a notorious wallflower became the life of the party. The spooks were having their midnight fling. The merrymaking was in full swing. Vince rigged themselves into a cheerful trance when the skeleton in the closet started to dance.
Didn't get to go as crazy with the Halloween decorations this year as I wanted to, but I was able to have a little bit of fun with it. Isn't that right, Jack?
From the Ghastly household to yours, happy Halloween.